Hello everyone, welcome to Alpha Gorilla's SAT 2 Math 2C 10 Practice Test course. Okay, so today we are going to start with the 9 tests of our practice test. Okay, so we will start right away. Let's start with the question number 1. Okay, so the question number 1. If f and x is equal to x plus 3, then f2 is. Okay, we don't even need to write something on board about this problem. Okay, simply you put 2 in place of x, then you get 5 as the answer. Therefore, the E5 is the answer. Okay, easy question. As I probably told you so many times before, the question number 1 through 15 are probably the easiest question on the math test, so I won't spend too much time on these kind of questions. Okay, so let's see. Look at number 2. The 7th term of 243, 81, 27 is. Okay, so we see some kind of sequence here, but what is the rule here? Right. This time 1 over 3 and times 1 over 3, right? So how do we find out the arithmetic sequence, the nth term of the geometric sequence is the initial figure times the rate of difference times n minus 1, right? Therefore, in this case, we're looking for the 7th term of this geometric sequence is equal to the initial number, it was 243, right, times the rate was 1 over 3. 7 minus 1. If you solve this, it will be 1 over 3, right? So if you're familiar with how to find the nth term of the geometric sequence, this was a very easy question as well. The number, the correct answer should be C. Okay, let's move on to number 3. Number 3 says, what is the ratio of the surface area of two different spheres, each with the radius of 2r and 3r? Okay, this is probably, this is elementary. The ratio of distance, when there's ratio of distance, and when there is a ratio of surface area, we know the ratio of this distance was 2r to 3r, right? This ratio of the surface area got to be the square of the ratio of the distance, right? Therefore, it becomes 2r to the square 2, 3r square. In other words, it is 4r square to 9r square. Therefore, it is 4 to 9, right? What about the ratio of the volume? Right, as you probably know, it is the third power of the ratio of the distance. So it will be 8 to, in this case, 27, right? But that was the ratio of the volume. But in this case, we are looking for a certain ratio of the surface area. Therefore, the answer got to be 4 to 9. 4 to 9, B is our correct answer. Okay, let's move on to the next question. If gx is 3x and fx is 2, and hx is negative 2 plus 3, then what is the combination of this fgh function? Okay, so let's start one by one. First, we need to solve this first, right? Since gx is 3x, you put 1 in place of x and you get 3, right? So this is 3. Now, we got to solve f3, but whatever you put in place of x for f and x function, you always get 2, right? So here, whole thing was equal to 2. Then now we are looking for h2 value, and we're given the equation here. Therefore, just put 2 in place of x, you will get negative 4 plus 3, right? It's equal to negative 1. So B is the answer. Okay, let's move on to the next question. If t1 is equal to 0.5 and tn is equal to this figure, then the tk is. Okay, for this kind of problem, we should find several terms first. Let's look for t2, t3.